of the thyroid gland. This is the arch of the aorta. It gives off the brachiocephalic trunk, the common carotid artery, the left one, and the left subclavian artery. Now, the left subclavian artery is divided into different parts by the scalenous muscle, and I will not go into the details of this artery. However, I can easily demonstrate to you the in one of its branches here, the internal mammary or the internal thoracic artery, which runs parallel to the sternum and supplies the intercostal spaces and, of course, the breast. Opposite to it here, as you can see, this artery, which is going to the vertebral canal through foramen transversarium, this is the vertebral artery. Now, if we go to this area, we can see this artery here. This is the common carotid. This is the inferior thyroid artery. It is long and tortuous, ascends up from the thyrocervical trunk and goes horizontally running towards the inferior pole of the thyroid gland. So this is the inferior thyroid artery at its best, coming from the thyrocervical trunk, from the subclavian artery, and it goes up and then medially to join the lower pole of the thyroid gland. Now, it is important when we operate on the thyroid gland to wear ligate the artery. Now, either you ligate away from the gland or near the gland. So what determines this is this nerve. This is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. Here is the vagus nerve, okay, on this side. It turns around and gives off the recurrent laryngeal nerve below the arch of the aorta on the left side and on the right side below the subclavian artery. Now, I will demonstrate to you this nerve on the left side. As you can see, this is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. I can be sure that this is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. So what is interesting about this nerve is this relation. This is the inferior thyroid artery and this is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. If you are a surgeon and you wanna remove the gland, it would be much easier for you to ligate this artery away from the gland. Because if you ligate this artery here near to the nerve, you may injure or accidentally ligate the recurrent laryngeal nerve, which is very important to the voice box or the larynx. So again, this is the inferior thyroid artery coming from the subclavian thyrocervical trunk to supply the lower pole of the thyroid gland. In its way, coming back to the larynx is this nerve, the recurrent laryngeal nerve, to reach up the larynx. So you need to be aware of this relation. The blood supply to the thyroid gland. It takes its blood supply from the external carotid artery. It gives off a branch named the superior thyroid artery to supply this area, the upper pole of the thyroid gland. So this is the common carotid artery, and this is now here in the external carotid, this one here, this one is the external carotid artery. It is the medial one here. You may think this is the internal. No, it's not. This is the external because it gives off branches here. And the other one, this one here, deep, okay, it is the internal carotid artery. Now, the external carotid artery gives off branches, branch to the thyroid gland. This is not the artery, this is the vein, the superior thyroid vein. The artery is was here, but it has been cut. It looks like this vein coming from the external carotid artery to supply this area of the gland. Now, what is interesting about this artery is that it has a relation with a branch of the vagus nerve. The vagus nerve gives off a branch, we call it the external laryngeal nerve. This nerve is going to the larynx. The artery, though, is going to the thyroid gland. So one of them is going above, while the artery is going down. However, as they come from their origins, the artery from the external carotid and the nerve from the vagus nerve, they are close to each other. But when they go down or up to the, towards their final target, they diverge. So if you want to ligate the superior thyroid artery, much better would be to ligate the artery near the gland. So we've mentioned today two arteries, the inferior thyroid artery to be ligated away from the gland to avoid injury to the recurrent laryngeal. On the other hand, we've mentioned the superior thyroid artery, and we said that it has a relationship with the external laryngeal nerve. And we will ligate the artery near the gland because the nerve and the artery are in close relation to each other at their origin.